Welcome back to the workshop for the first build of 2019, January 1st. We're starting off with something big. Go big or go home. Well, you don't get much bigger in plastic model kits than the 1/9 scale Ketton Crod from Italeri, all right? It is a big, big, beautiful kit. We're not gonna show you every single part in the model, but we are gonna show you some stuff that's gonna make you say, what? Right there, all right? Vinyl parts to replicate the rear seat, to replicate the driver's seat. Look at my hand, 1/9 scale, gigantic. Drive belts, we've got tie downs with holes in them. Scales this big, you get a lot of detail in the package. Check out that sweet Continental front tire. You saw the Ketton Crod in the movie Saving Private Ryan. We've got a screen for the engine grills. We've got some vinyl hosing in here and various springs because it is a live suspension on the model. Now let's throw some sprues out here. You wanna know how big it is? The sprues are 2 feet across. Yeah, they hardly fit on camera. That's the chassis. Look at the size of it. This thing is gonna be absolutely gargantuan. Let me pull that out of the way. We're going to show you some of the fine detail. Then we're going to get right into building because this has got a lot of stuff to work on. All right. Helmets are included. German brain buckets. We've got machine guns. All right. We've got tie downs. We've got tools and wrenches. And I, like I said, you know, you look at that axe to my hand, I could almost use it for real. We got turnbuckles and tie downs and all kinds of cool stuff. We'll just pile a bunch of plastic up here as we look at it. We've got suspension components coming up here. We've got grills. Check it out. Wing nuts. All right. Lots of detail. We've got our dashboard right there. On this huge tree coming out, we've got our four-cylinder engine. That is just sweet. We got little tiny spark plugs. Look at them. That's adorable. Engine fans. This is a reissue of a much older kit, but I don't see any flash on it or anything to worry about. We've got tracks. Luckily for me, they snap together and then we glue the pads on. We've got 2-hole trees to assemble 2 sets of live tracks that will move. You can see they snap together with the pin and the hook, and then the pads will glue on the top, and then we will paint, weather those, and assemble them onto the model. The wheels, the drive wheels and the road wheels are huge. This thing's gonna be so much fun to build. And I can't wait to get it outdoors for some pictures too when we're all done. It is a big, big kit. Massive. Front wheel is the last tree. That's a big front wheel with a little valve stem on it. We've got our fender. We've got, check out those nuts. Check out these nuts. All right, hilarious. Big pieces. Shock parts, everything. Just massive. Even the clear parts tree for the headlight, the marker lights. They're all huge. All that plastic is in the kit. And we've got a beautiful set of decals for 3 different versions. Russian front, Italian front, however you want to paint it up. There are full instructions. And the instructions themselves are a big book. Just a huge book of how to put everything together. So, I'm gonna get these parts degreased. I'm gonna start working. We'll come back for some sub-assembly show-offs. Working on the Ketton Crod now. I've made it up to about page 5, and that gets us as far as you see here. There's still 10 more pages to go of assembly, so we're not as far as you think we would. In fact, we've got a ton of parts left that I need to use on the bench. But page 5 gets you all the way to this. And this is a lot of stuff. We've got all of our drive and road and idler wheels all done. They all pair up with each other. They all fit together nicely. The glue's drying on those. We've got the main hull done, and they wanted me to put the floor in. So what I wanted to do was make sure I showed you what was inside there before I sealed it up. But you can see the sheer size of that thing. I mean, you can measure it, you know, on the inches across the board. You can see it in my hands. That is a big mamma jamma. Those are just the front little lights on it and everything. It is a huge piece of styrene that goes together. Now inside you will see down in there that we've got actual metal springs and working suspension. On the outside, the suspension will actually move up and down. So if you want to pose it, if you want to use it like so, You won't have any issue doing so. They move up and down. You can put it on a rocky terrain and the tracks will form and fold to it. So that's all down in there. All that assembly looks real nice, and I've got a ton of glue on this to hold it all together. Don't be surprised if you go through an entire bottle of glue. So it sits nice and level. It's going to be absolutely awesome. Some of the seams are a little big on there, so I may go through and fill those with putty, whatever the glue doesn't hold together nicely. I can just squirt some thick CA in there or some putty and have it seize up. Now what they want me to do next is attach the drive wheels and all the road wheels. I'm not going to do that because obviously I have to paint everything separately, so I want to paint it open like this. And they've got pins that slide in there that I will be inserting before I paint it so that those holes stay wide open for me. I'm gonna keep assembling. If I come across any issues, I'll let you know. Otherwise, we'll just come back as I get bigger sub-assemblies done and start putting things together progressing. See you soon. At this point, all the sub-assemblies you see, I've got about 5 hours worth assembly in. I haven't done any seam filling or any cleanup. I'm gonna use my thick CA glue and run it in the beads and everything to do the seam work for me. And then I'll sand things down like the radiator shroud with the operating door on the back to close it off when it's cold. That's what I'm assuming. The dashboard is all right there. And look at that fine assembly down there on the guard over the top of the transmission. That's just absolutely beautiful. All the fine detail on there. And of course you can see my glue is tinted orange from the last kit I built with orange paint on it. So you can easily see where I put the glue. Even down to the little 6-volt battery. All right, and that's going to mount inside one of these compartments, which do both open. You have to build the hinges for them. They both open. They both look awesome. We've got the driver's seat. Let me get some of this stuff out of the way. We've got the driver's seat assembly and controls done. Oh, look at that. All those teeny tiny parts to be glued together. Springs for the seat. Everything. All right, now, a lot of the stuff I don't have on here are the vinyl knobs and the vinyl seat, some of the vinyl parts of the dashboard and whatnot. All that stuff I'm not going to attach at this point. I'm going to paint the model, then I can attach the vinyl parts on it. I don't want to try to paint over vinyl because it'll never dry unless I use some sort of an acrylic, and I'm going to be using acrylics to weather it, so once it's attached, I can weather it. The engine is an entire kit all on its own. It is just unreal. We'll go by real slow. I mean, the fan, the belt system is a vinyl belt, so I can leave it all off, paint the engine one color, like it would have been on the assembly line, I assume, and then weather and dirty it up and then attach that belt at the very end. I have the distributor on and the coil on. I do not have the plugs in the four-cylinder or the plug wires. Those will come later for obvious reasons. I do not want to paint over them. The spark plugs are right there. Hooey, I'm gonna get those painted and then I'll be able to attach those to the distributor and everything after the engine, just about before it's ready to go in. These are some of the nut detail you will see on the model in various places. They have a hole in the back. They have you cut it out and then attach it over certain areas. A good place to see that detail is on the side of these little controls here. All right, the little foot controls are right there. You can see all the little detail on there. You can see all the little detents on the handles. The superb, I mean, it's a beautiful kit. I've never built one of these large-scale motorcycles before, and I'm really glad that I started with this one because I haven't had any problems aside from the being there a bajillion pieces and, you know, an hour and a half, 2 hours on the engine alone. That's just, you know, work. That's not, it's not bad. So I'm not having any issues. I thought I might because these Italeri kits, Italeri kits are older kits. I think they're left over from ESSI, ESCI or MI, one of those older model companies. You can see we've completed the runners and the storage bins. It looks like fuel tanks. We'll find that out. All on the side of the main chassis. We showed you the main chassis before. Now we've got these tanks on either side and storage bins, one of them which holds our battery. We've got controls on the inside now. We've got a nice long runner. This goes all the way back to the radiator shroud. I've test fitted everything. It does fit nice and tightly. Parts like that will go in the dashboard. Then you would assemble your seat in the front, and it's a very tight fit in there, so I don't want to shove it in there and break anything, but it'll go in there. The engine drops in really sweet. The engine just plops in right like so. And then our giant radiator shroud, you get it around those coolant lines, and you drop that in carefully. And that's how that's going to look with the engine back there when we've got the engine cover off and whatnot. That's going to sit back there. It'll be glued in more securely, straight up and down. And that's how that beast is going to look when it's all assembled. So to say that this kit is detailed is an understatement of epic proportions. It is absolutely phenomenal. I still have 4 pages of building left. You can see I've still got the front wheel, all the front forks, all the detail parts, and some larger body parts like engine covers to assemble before I can even get this in my paint. So I'm gonna keep working, I'm gonna keep plugging away, and just before I'm ready to go and paint, we'll stop, take another look at where we're sitting. After what is literally about 9 hours worth of assembly time, we're finally ready to start getting some paint on stuff. You saw a lot of the parts before. We've got the full front end on the Kettenkrad, and that looks really cool. I did have some issues with the small parts of the front handlebar assembly being extremely brittle. And I'm, you know, it's probably just a bad injection of plastic on that one. So I did break a lot of parts and I had to fix them with super glue. That's why the front kind of looks like a mess of glue right now, because it's all discolored with the super glue and the super glue accelerator. Once we get some black spray paint, which is what we're going to cover all this with as a primer, that will go away. It'll start to meld in. It just looks so very odd with the different colors on there. We've got this whatever it is on the back of it. It holds the tail light. Got some cool wing nuts on the back, held down by straps over the hitch. That is assembled onto the back of the Kettenkrad. We've got our steering and seat there. We have our engine shroud we showed you. We've got our dashboard that we showed you. We've got the engine, which is just, man, wow. We've got all the road wheels and drive wheels. We kind of talked about that earlier. Since we last spoke, I got the headlight together. I didn't put the ring on it. I want to paint it and then put all the clear glass in. We got the bottom of the rear seat that'll seat 2 or 3 guys across there. Bet you it'll seat 6 if you're running from the enemy. We've got that nice grill opening for the air intake for the engine. I have just press fit this on. I'll paint it all, get all the paint on it. Then I'll be able to pull this off gently, put the screen in there and push it back on and glue it in place. And then we've got our screen in there that stays black because that's why I want to leave it. So it just draws a little bit of attention to itself. We've got our rear seat with its little guards here. The hinges are operational and the side braces. This will actually mount behind the engine and flip forward so they can get to and work on the engine. Our tracks are all assembled. 42 links, 42 pads. Oh, it's just, it's a lot of work. They snap together, but then you have to glue each individual pad on to hold them together. So instead of using my big bonding brush, which gets in there and it's got that big brush, what I like to do then is use, to me, a thin cement, which has a very lovely, super thin, precise applicator. And that lets me get in there and apply those. But as you can see, the tracks are flexible. They will go on. There's one pad left off, so that when we loop them around and attach them in the final steps after painting and weathering, we put that final piece together there after it's on the vehicle, and then we'll glue our last pad across the top and give it a coat of quick paint and a little bit of weathering, and then we have our beautiful track set. So that came out real nice. It is time consuming, you know, 42 links per side plus pads snapped and glued together, but they go together well and they turn out real nice. They have real nice design to them. Gonna paint the individual halves of the wheel and then press them together around the tire and glue them together. Everything else you've seen before, the front end will still steer. You can hear it going back and forth. We've got our fender on with our placard and our braces. Talk about an extremely detailed kit. So I have to go and use about an entire can of black spray paint. All these spare parts back here are accessories. It's completely up to you what you want to use. We've got shovels, helmets, we've got machine guns, we've got even the interior for the helmets, the padding. We've got tow hooks. We've got hand tools, all kinds of stuff. None of that has to be worried about right now. I want to get paint on the main vehicle, get that painted, and I can always work on the accessories I want to use at any time after that. Throw some primer on them and then start putzing with those and using the ones I want and not using the ones I don't. Let me get some black paint. Then we're going to cover it with that beautiful Krylon Wild Oats that I've used before. I'm going to show you that also before we close the video out. I'll come back when we got some color. A nice coat of paint over the black primer really comes out well. It starts to look real nice, real weathered, beat up. You can see how you get all these cool accents on the wheel when you use a black primer and then mist over it with your color coat. You don't want to hose the thing down. We're not painting a car, but it really has a nice mottled effect. It might not show up extremely well on cameras, but you can see that kind of yellow. You can see the black through it. You can really see it on here where all those little screw heads are, where it accentuates all the detail on there and looks wonderful. These wheels look amazing with that tone on there. We'll go through the paints used later. I did paint the engine a gloss green. Now, I had seen some restored ones online. I don't want a bunch of comments about, well, it's not the proper color. A whole bunch of different ones online. Some had white engines, some had red engines, some had green engines. Some were painted the same color as the chassis, as the body was. The same Dunkelgaub yellow, you know. Some were, you know, a different color. So it really didn't make a difference. There was so many different colored four-cylinder engines in them. However, they were painted. Green looked nice to me, and now I just have to go out and pick out the hose details. I have to wire my spark plugs, get those painted, put those in, and then detail the engine, and that's ready to drop in. Everything else comes out looking really, really sharp. I just love how this is going to look with that yellow on the body. Oh, that's so awesome. It just looks delicious, gives it the right amount of shadows. Everything looks phenomenal. All this really needs is final assembly, decals, and weather. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get some black paint on the edges of the wheels here, all the different wheels. I'm going to stick a pin through the hole and then just roll it in paint. That's it. Just putting paint on a cheap sponge and just rolling it through. These are big enough, and just pushing down a little bit will get me that sidewall coverage. You can see the tracks here look awesome. I did them in a black primer, then I hit them with a red primer, then I hit them with just a really, really light mist of the body color, and they look really cool. All these need is a dry brushing and a little bit of black washing, so we'll get on that. When we come back, we'll have the decals on, we'll have it assembled. We won't have the wheels on it yet because I want to weather it with the wheels off of it, and I don't want to break anything off, and I want to weather the tracks off the vehicle, but we'll at least have a lot of the assemblies done. We'll have the vinyl together. We'll get another look soon. At this point, the major assembly is done, aside from road wheels and tracks on there, but we've got everything on. We've got the rear seat together, and of course, it all looks a little too clean right now, but we're working on that. We've got that all set up. The rear seat will still lean forward, just like it should. You can see part of the engine back there. You can see them hiding back there. And you can see that I've weathered the inside of the engine bay using one of my favorite weathering materials, a transparent raw umber acrylic ink, which will go over everything and never harm it and make it look awesome. Just wanted to make it look a little oily and dirty. I've got the front end on. Now, I didn't glue the dashboard in because it holds itself in nice and tight. The only time, in fact, you ever notice anything is a little off is when you move the front steering. You can hear it click behind there. There's a little spring back there that's clicking. But otherwise, everything is in place. We'll lift it up. You can see the driver's compartment. I've made it nice and dirty. I just need to get in there with a brush and do some mild chip effects on the inside where his feet would be rubbing, grabbing the handles and stuff. We have to dust up all the vinyl. You can look at that beautiful grill. You can actually see the engine behind it, and that is operational as well. Let me get a finger wedged in there. And the seat's springy, just like it should be on those springs. There we go. And you can open that up and see that beautiful engine. And that looks real sweet in there. I detailed that all up. I put the spark plug wires on, and then I washed it down with some oily washes, and then I got it glued into the engine bay. So that looks awesome. All I have to do for more compartment work is finish the battery and stick it in its side compartment here. I'm working on the front tire. You can see what I'm going to be doing with the road wheels. I'm rubbing some burnt sienna on a dry brush method all over the wheel. Then I'm taking a rag and I'm wiping it out, and it's leaving it in just the most prominent areas. You can see one side's got a little more crust on it than the other, and that's completely fine. But we're doing some chip effects using sculpting tools, which work better than my fingernail. I beat up my fingernail last time and peeled it half off. So we've got that all going in there. We're working hard on that. We've got to dust up the tire with some tile grout, and then we'll be putting that on the front end, and that area will be done. I'm going to be doing the exact same thing with the road wheels and the entire body. Got to mess it up first after I get the front wheel attached and I get the road wheels on and the tracks on before I get to dust those up. After weathering them, I will need to place all my decals on, so when I weather the main body, I'm weathering over the decals and I'm not placing decals over existing weathering. I'm going to keep working on it. When I get it all assembled and the decals on, we'll come back for a look before I really dirty it up. Assembly, major assembly, and decaling is complete. We've got it all ready to go here. What do I need to do now? Well, you can see it looks amazing. I need to let the decals sit and dry. I put a little bit of Tamiya Mark Fit on there to get them around those small areas down there and around the dashboard and whatnot. Once the dashboard is completely dry, I'll drip in some Future on those gauges. Then we're going to start weathering, and I've shown you how I do weathering in my Hitachi front end loader review, so we won't go through all that again, but I'm going to be using some tile grout in various colors to make a big dust effect on everything. I will be using my beloved transparent raw umber ink to make some oil and mud and other stains. I'll be using jet black to chip it down to the primer by tearing fine little pieces off that sponge and holding them in tweezers and dabbing it in the chipped areas. And I'll be using some of the burnt sienna, like I did on the wheels, to simulate some ground in dirt and a little bit of surface rust. We're not going to completely shred this thing and pretend that it got all rusted and rotted within a couple years on scene. So we're going to keep working. I've got a couple hours worth of work left. When we come back, we're going to have a nice final. And here we are at the final. I want to give you guys a nice look under the hood of this beauty. I mean, this I love this kit. You know, I do have the BMW with sidecar, and I also have the WLA. So if you guys like a build like this in the large scale, just let me know. But I did dirty up the interior. What I used on the gauges was Future over the decals, and then dusted it up, and then I dirtied and chipped everything up with a sponge. So we'll close this off, and we'll put the camera down, and we will give you a look. Come for a ride with me there. We'll give you a look at the whole model. Now, this thing is just fantastical. Using my normal weathering techniques, I showed you that all on the Hitachi front end loader, how to do the chipping, how to do the weathering on Rommel's rod. What I use is I cut off a piece of sponge, and then I use a forceps and I just dab it with black paint all over the vehicle in spots where you're going to get a lot of wear, such as around the back here where you have soldiers' feet and they're kicking while they're climbing up and getting down and grabbing the handles. You're going to have a lot of paint chips there. You're going to have a lot of paint chips around the top of the tracks where when they've got branches and gunk on them, they're going to bring it and sling it around. I've got fuel spills on both of the fuel tanks. Cool trivia, each one of these fuel tanks will hold a jerry can worth of fuel. I didn't know that, 21 gallons each. So we got some chips around the fender and the forks where we're going to be scraping as we go around stuff. Then I applied my normal tile grout. I applied my transparent umber. I applied some lighter tile grout to dust effects. We've got some additional things like the machine gun, which we can hang like so. We've got an extra helmet. We got a bunch of extra helmets. This one I left painted gray as if it was an older helmet. We'll throw it back there. Here we've got one done up in the tan, so you know you can throw that on there. We've got one over the front steering. The front steering still works. You can turn it back and forth, and the tracks will rotate. We've got full suspension on there. So just amazing. The decals went down perfectly. The hood goes down right. If you pay attention to it the first time, but trying to do it on video while holding a camera is a little rough. And then the vinyl seats, I just dusted up when I applied them. It's because obviously those wouldn't stay clean very long. It's an absolutely gorgeous kit. I loved every second about it. The paints that I used on this kit were Rust-Oleum Black Primer, and then overcoated that with a Krylon Wild Oats. And it comes out with that absolute beautiful, beautiful coloration, and it just looks phenomenal. I love that. That large scale really stands out. You can really go crazy with the detailing, and if you wanted to do rust, this thing wasn't out in the field, as far as my little backstory goes, nearly long enough to get any rust on it, but it did have a little surface beat up. The tracks are a little crusty because they're bare metal to begin with and everything like that. Now with the technique, how did I get the black on the road wheels? I said we'd talk about that. I use a sponge, dollar store car wash sponge, and I cut about 6 strips out of it. What I do is lay paint in the colors that I want to use, whether they're metallic to weather the road wheels here, the drive wheel, which will chip because it's all metal, or the other ones were done with a pavement color, 50 cent Walmart pavement color, and then all I do is I just roll the wheel through the sponge. The sponge will push down enough that it will get the black on the wheels, and you don't have to sit there with a circle cutter and try to get them on there. That's one of my preferred techniques for getting black tires on steel wheels on armored vehicles. So you can see everything comes out real nice. It assembles beautifully. There's no issues at all. I had a great time with it. Highly recommend it. Google the Italeri and the part number. That's the most recent release. Revell has released this. Dragon has released it. SC back in the day is the first people to come out with it. And you'll get a lot of cool stuff in there. So we will see you at the next review. Coming up next is the brand new Revell 68 Chevelle. See you soon on the workshop.